The Nanut isn't scheduled to return from the Gamma Quadrant for 2 years.
Actually, I planned on staying considerably longer.
I don't follow.
Commander, I'm going to tell you a story. And you may even believe it.
I'm listening.
During the occupation, I was a member of a minor resistance cell. Name is unimportant. One day, this was in the mountains surrounding the Sauvang Valley. We were ambushed by Cardassian troops. Only three of us managed to escape. We hid in the hills for 2 days. Finally, the lack of food and water forced us down into the valley. We made our way to a ridge overlooking a small lake. As I was the only one still carrying a phaser, I went on ahead to scout for the enemy. Halfway down the embankment, I slipped. Went sprawling on my back down to the edge of the lake just as a huge Cardassian emerged from the water. He must have just finished bathing. He stood there, frozen in surprise, dressed only in his underwear, shivering in the cold. I lay there looking up at him, too stunned to even move, and it was only when he reached for a phaser rifle that was lying across his clothes on a nearby rock that I realized that I was still holding my own phaser, and I shot him. His body fell on top of me, and that's how my companions found us a moment later. One of them recognized him as Gul Zurael, responsible for the massacre of half a dozen Bajoran villages. Now, I tried to tell them what had happened, but they had already convinced themselves that I had killed Zurael in some kind of a savage struggle, which is what they insisted on telling every Bajoran that we met. And no matter how hard I tried to deny it, the story continued to spread until it seemed all of Bajor had heard it. Soon, every victory won by the resistance was attributed to my leadership. Stories of my brilliance, my daring, my courage grew more and more unbelievable. Yet the people insisted on believing them. My reputation even followed me into the labor camp, where my mere presence seemed to inspire my fellow prisoners. And I had done nothing but shoot an unarmed Cardassian in his underwear. And I'll never forget the look on his face when he died. He was so embarrassed. So you see, Commander, I have done what Bajor needed me to do. I have allowed myself to be a slave to my reputation all of these years. And now, it is enough.
They still need you.
But I am not the man that they think I am.
Perhaps not. But Bajor doesn't need a man. He needs a symbol. And that's what you are. No one's asking you to lead troops into battle or to kill 100 Cardassians with your bare hands. I saw you in front of the crowd on the promenade. They look at you and they see strength and honor and decency. They look at you and see the best in themselves.
But it's all based on a lie.
No, it's based on a legend. And legends are as powerful as any truth. Bajor still needs that legend. It needs you.